to find, you want to look for the date. And then there it is. So it's loading up, and we're going to see the huge hitch right before it ends. Probably that. So, what's going on? iOS device helper, you sleep. Okay, so I'm just gonna go to the game thread, see if there's anything there. Shader compiling thread? Net tick time, channel receive raw bunch. Blueprint time, script on rep, replicated movement. Update overlaps time. Wooden plank. Okay, interesting. The beginning component overlaps of all the items stacked on top of each other. So items should ignore each other, right? So if I go to Blueprint Interactables, that's really funny. I'm glad this actually showed me what is going on. And let's go to item, actually. Right, with the world model of it. And just all of these collision presets, multiple values. Alright, just make sure they all ignore items somehow. Object type is world dynamic. So... now, which one is it though? Wait, let's look at this. You got interact sphere. And another one here, begin component overlap self. Interact sphere. Delete signature. So it's just the interact sphere. Yeah, that definitely shouldn't interact with itself. Interact sphere should should also ignore that. We only want it to overlap these guys. And wait, what is this even being used for? Hold on. I feel like I need to get rid of some of these and just boil it down to like the look at and the interact should be the same thing. I guess one of them is like the interact channel there. And the other one is this interact sphere. It's a world static thing, maybe you're interacting with it. Let's see if that helps. Now this is funny, the reason why we don't usually see it is because we don't usually have 1,000 wooden planks stacked on top of each other somewhere. So this is the kind of stuff that comes up through actual playtesting that you have to look at. Because you have to have. I want to go out and do a test with the guys and girls, this holiday season, whether it's Halloween, no, Thanksgiving, or Christmas, or New Year's. I'm not sure, but and do like build as much as possible everywhere in the world, and just fill a save game with houses and stuff, and just see how it performs, see what kind of bottlenecks we can find, see if I can increase the performance. You know, that would be fun. I could probably do that myself, but okay, this is the part here. Let's see if, first of all, let's see if items work, if I can do stuff with them. Okay. Seems good. Okay. So it was registering all of the collisions of all of those items. For some reason the server it's like already handled before you load in, I guess. This needs to receive the data, so it's different. I'm just gonna do the crouching thing. See if items load in. Because it was when items load in, that was a thing. They were all getting registered all at once. We don't want them to register overlaps with each other. It's still choppy, but not nearly as bad. Not nearly as bad. Yeah, that was a lot better. A lot better. So, I want to do the... I'll disconnect. And I'll log in again. And I'm going to do the record session again. And see how it compares now. Stop saving COD on the server. Pardon me. Good to get the crunchies out. So now we gotta load a different one. Spawn actor, instance actor component, firelight with light weight, child actor component, particle system component. These are pretty small register components. Blueprint time. On rep replicated movement. And also on rep color name and color. Okay. I think it's the fact that they're always relevant. There's a problem with not being always relevant with the world model thing, is that they're not always relevant if they're hidden in-game and somewhere else in the world. I'm gonna hit a mole, but I think it's probably the problem. It's not too big of a deal, honestly. Like, we loaded like 1,000 actors or whatever, and it's just like a couple seconds of a hitch. I might be able to do some sort of loading screen wait time for that, and maybe get to it faster by doing the hand models. Whatever, sooner? I'm not sure. I could also try net load on client, which would make connecting to the server take longer. It wouldn't cause a hitch once you're. So I'm going to try for now netload on client. Actually, let me look this again. Did I close it? So it's item, not the hand models. It's item and move component. Well, it's a static mesh. The mesh itself shouldn't have any updates. Oh, here it is, sphere component. Interact sphere. 7 out of 18. I love how they just disappear. I'll hear updates over time and begin component overlap. Self. Alright, and self again here. Static mesh component though. Some overlap. Oh, that's what. That's what the other thing. Though the other thing's interact sphere is overlapping with the static mesh. So. Mesh is a world dynamic overlap visibility. I need to. Working with custom ones is hard because then you have a standard setting on them and then you have to go through every item and change it how you want. It's just. I kind of wish there was one more here that was like. Volume or collision volume or like, you know, other volume. I don't know. I should create one, but this one's fine. This one has problems. Probably because the interact sphere, I feel like this is world static, so it's actually this one, but it should be blocking world static. This one should not be world static. Maybe this one should be look at sphere. So I do have a thing set up for that, where this one is look at sphere. Let me see if I can still interact with stuff when I change that. And if that helps. Then the mesh should ignore that sphere, and the interact sphere should ignore the mesh of other items, and hopefully the player can still interact with them. It's funny that those register components is such a huge thing, but that's the stuff you don't know unless you have a thousand actors in the game to find out, like all sitting on top of each other with overlap volumes and stuff, you know? Yeah, test it in action, piece by piece. So first I'll just check that I can do stuff. And click on stuff. I don't think mouse over is working. Like, at all? It should be coming up when I mouse over things. the heck? What's that got to do with? Was it in overlapping with the items somehow? Before? Like the mouse is changing, but the mouse over thing's not showing up. I know we just saw it recently too. Ooh, I've clicked on a quest. Ooh, there's another one. Anyway, okay. Okay. Drop the thing. Get the thing. Looks good. I need a left hand pickup animation. So let's see if it helped performance then. It seems like everything's working fine except for just the mouse over stuff, which is fine because that's easy enough to switch just the one thing. Everything else is okay. I don't know why that would have happened from items getting changed though, because I was mouse overing characters. I'm gonna have to do this somewhere else. It's kind of annoying. I guess just when it's activated, I have to change the world model. That's easy enough. And that might help fix another part, too. For the swapping hands. So, hand model. Let's fix that real quick. Should be doing it already. Maybe that was just not doing anything anyway. Maybe it was failing some other stuff because of that. Maybe it was just going through. Just not doing that one node. I thought usually when they fail, they just don't do anything after that. But I guess it's not the case. Try the look button. I did try interacting though. Character, I mean the server doesn't seem to have to do anything. Any loading of that stuff, registering. I wonder if I change it to net load on client, that'll be better. But I wanted to... yeah, the torch thingy. Swapping hands works. It was like probably overriding it because it didn't know what it was doing. Alright, there's a lantern. I put that in a wall like 2 days ago. Let's check that out real quick. Its left hand thing needs to be switched. This is on the server too. Change anything with the interact spheres? Let's see if this is any better. If not, I want to do 3. There's the hitch. And it's done. Let's see if once I've made a character, does it do the same thing? No. So I wonder if maybe if I just wait before logging in, if it'll happen before logging in a character. And let's get that lantern. Yeah, okay, it's the same. Alright, cool, I just need to fix its rotation. This is a great track. This is just wrong, so let's just delete it and do the same like we did before. Oh, type 0. Let's do 2 characters loading in just to test that waiting theory. Drum when I can't hear myself because my headphones are too loud. Alright, so 0 is like that. I don't want session front-end right now. This guy. Okay. I saw it, like, oh, maybe if, like, when I'm in the middle of the, That doesn't make sense. Why would the save game reference disappear? I wonder if because the save game's already messed up. I need to clear that. We need to start with a new one. I'm not gonna have all those thousands of planks overlapping each other right now. To test that with. It wasn't too bad though, I mean it was already pretty well improved. Herbalism, I gotta do herbalism and alchemy too. Nice. Be back a second and get some yogurt. Talk less as I eat. Fail. This isn't bad for a mix of two songs. something to take note of is that I said if you have two actors that are, well, sure de long, I think I said that right, probably not, said that if you have actors that are basically always loaded, it's kind of okay to reference them anyway, because they're always going to be in memory anyway, so like the controller and the pawn, I think I can just... Just do a cast here. I could even refer it to pure cast, probably. But hold on. You might already be a horse. Horse is already before this, so it could be a horse. I wasn't a horse, or it failed there, so that wouldn't be it. Remember there was a problem with the battling spawn too. It wasn't like replacing the character. I went but my microphone wasn't on. But put a note about that thing with the static meshes. that. This crap. Did I hit host game twice? Yeah, I did. Found it, okay. Oops. Now it wants to work, huh?
You must choose a form. You must choose a form.
I think maybe that one thing that I did might have fixed it. The new save. Did I actually do anything though? Oh, that's right, I changed it to a cast to third person instead of doing a thing, so I mean, seems like it's working, but I thought I did that before the last time I tried testing. I guess not. I lose track of things sometimes, you know. Okay, back to the offhand offset for this. It's hard to tell which direction exactly that is. And a quest is... Okay, I got my mouse over. But only for a quest. Oh, a desk chair? Yeah, that's definitely broken all of a sudden. Up the thing. I'm not sure which one's the server here. I could have just looked on the left here. Nah, that was the other one. Correct. It's gotta be this one then. Don't know which direction. There's definitely not a twist around. And again, this might be applied to that weird offset, which just make the whole thing a mess. Shit, I think it is. Well, it doesn't seem like it did anything. Like, neither of those rotations. Thing. Well, we can get rid of this here. Checking if the offset. There we go. both of these. So if either of them is not, then it'll do false. So if it's coming through with blank stats, then just ignore. But if it has either one of these, then do the thing. That's a thing, because I wasn't changing the location offset, so I wasn't getting any. It was bypassing. So I'm gonna check again. Test here. Left-hand offset. Y, and then I'll do X. Try the Y. What? Wait, what? Confused. I thought I changed it. Like, where did I change? Change. I feel like I changed this, maybe? I don't think I did. I think I was here, I changed that, and it just didn't apply. We'll find out if everything's twisted around by 90 degrees, I guess. Like the torches, for example, they didn't have a rotation on before. Isn't happening. Maybe that's the post-process effect. No. No, it's not.
I guess what we're doing is essential. You know, just your body just, oh, it grew.
Okay. Why is this uncompiled? Like, how could this be uncompiled? Did I set this one's left hand offset to 90? No. Probably all that edit undo stuff. Must have been happening here, yeah. Weird that it's uncompiled. Try the X. None of them seemed to rotate it. I mean, I guess it could be Z. Also. Okay, but the question mark thing is working, that's important. And mouse overs are working. Even though it was item. I gotta test something. Is it that the items? Oh, it must be the question mark. No, that doesn't make any sense. I'm clicking the collision capsule. Okay, whatever. It works though. I'm not sure if the load in is gonna be as choppy though. Yes, it's not a skirt, it's a tunic. At least the mouse over and the quests are working, but now why? None of these rotation axes seem to work for this guy. What's up with that? Nobody wants the lantern to work right. Where's my lantern? It's in the backpack.
This is a dance floor, so whatever size booty you guys brought with you, you can bring it to the dance floor and shake your wang bang doodling all night long.
There it is. And that's the problem right there. I just think I heard something. It sounded like my doorbell. Hold on, I'll be right back. Nope, no it wasn't. This is the music. But this is the problem here. This is checking if this notification. Set relative transform to be this. Well, if I'm using set, and I don't need to do the adjustment. This should be no longer necessary. See, I didn't change it. Thank you. There we go. Alright, that would be this way, so no, we want the other direction. Okay. Yeah, and it's working for the not doing that. Okay, cool. Alright, perfect. Let's just put in the right thing then. Not as much. Maybe like 2/3 as much. That was 60 here. Or, I mean, 60 was here. 90 was like too far. How is that 90? And then that's 60. Rotators are weird. I'm using set, I'm not using combine. Combine is even weirder. Definitely want to avoid using combined rotators if you can. So checking the rotation of the left hand lantern. No. It's definitely not making logical sense to me. I can put the graphics back up too. Ooh, they are an epic. It's just the memory, the current time, or place be able. So this is 45. This is negative. I guess it has some standard one already, and that's why it's, yeah, its standard one is, well, let's copy that. Why is it changing each of them? Want to do that? It keeps correcting it to put flip it around because of the quaternals. Ah, that's better. That's gonna be the same now that I fucking hate rotators. Like, just let me enter the value that I want here, please. Such bullshit. So annoying. I know what it's doing, and I know why it's doing. It's just like I want to circumvent that because I want something different. Damn it! I want this exact. Oh, maybe I can copy, paste. Ah, now I can type in 150, and it does that. But isn't that what I was doing over there? And it worked. It just goes to 150. All right, I'll put it to 150. Copy it. Undo, and then I'll go here. I mean, it's pasting that in. Copy this one first. Okay. Still does it. To 150. I mean, let's just try that. Why not? That's the original. It should be no change. Just see that it's no change. Yeah, okay. Now we just want to add... Z rotation shouldn't matter. Ah, there we go. Stupid rotators. The torch is very bright, though. Thinking about it, I'm gonna fix that password button showing. You know what, maybe I should just check the Steam ID instead. It's a bit of effort. Yeah, I just want to do a quick fix for now. Okay. Alright. Oh no, all those items need to be changed. I don't know if that's good. Just hop in again, real quick. Very bright, and it looks like it's in the wrong spot. I love my AI. It's so weird. Hey, defend me. Yes. Perfect timing. Alright, with that, I think I'm going to call it a morning. That was awesome. Okay, I'm going to eat some lunch, and let's make note of something that I fixed here. Observed a possible hitch. client logins. Mesh overlap spheres when lots of items spawn are loaded. What's the other thing they just did basically? The lantern rotation. Mouse over. That was all stuff that was basically working before. Okay. Well, I'll be around. I'll probably come back later. Take a bake break. Bacon break. Yeah, good physics, right? Oh, there's all the chat. Let me see. Hey, Noice. What do you use to 3D model? I do Blender. I made the clothes in Blender. Why are you not talking to yourself now? Nice physics. Yeah, I don't know why I didn't see those messages. Restream. And then now here, Hadi says hi. I do see that. That's so weird. Okay, but what I was gonna reply to was the comment about, oh, the clothes. Yeah, I made the suit of armor here. I made all that in Blender too. It's not too good, but I'm proud of it. Especially the cuirass here, and figuring out the chain link thing, which I will have to try and puzzle over again one day when I do the rest of the chainmail. Be around. See you later.